Sam Brinton, a non-binary, cross-dressing thief and liar, has ruined the lives of countless people. You may remember Sam from his short-lived days in the United States Department of Nuclear Waste Removal, until he was fired for stealing expensive luggage from airport carousels. He tried to brazen it out and lie about it, but he was caught on camera, so that was kind of a no-go. But Sam's thievery was not the main way that he's hurt people. He was already a celebrity in LGBT activist circles well before the Biden administration appointed him to the U.S. Department of Nuclear Waste. He had been speaking literally around the world about his so-called conversion therapy. He claimed that he was subjected to psychological and physical torture to overcome his homosexual tendencies. He delivered this testimony to the United Nations Committee Against Torture. He was the poster child for the movement to ban any kind of counseling that addresses unwanted same-sex attraction. But here's the thing. Sam made it up. How do we know? Because Susan Constantine, a world-renowned expert on deception, examined Sam's testimonies closely. She and her team conducted a careful three-part analysis of his speech patterns, voice tremors, and body language. She revealed her results at a Ruth Institute event. She concluded that he was, quote, highly deceptive. In her presentation at the Ruth Institute Summit for Survivors of the Sexual Revolution, Ms. Constantine noted his subtle smirk that signals, quote, the duping delight. That is, this is a guy who takes pleasure in lying and seeing people fall for it. And she saw it written on his face. But we're not just here to slam Sam. We feel compassion for the many people around the world who experience same-sex attraction and would like some counseling. They have a variety of needs, dealing with unpleasant aspects of their current way of life, dealing with trauma that may have induced the feelings in the first place, and yes, there are some people who would like therapy that helps them lessen their feelings of same-sex attraction or gender confusion. But thanks in part to Sam's testimony, 27 U.S. states and several countries around the world have banned therapy for unwanted same-sex attraction. That's right. In many places, it's illegal to seek counseling if you want to exit the LGBT subculture. In parts of Australia, it's even illegal to pray for someone to lessen their unwanted same-sex attraction. Meanwhile, Ruth Institute Senior Research Associate Father Paul Sullins has been examining the statistical evidence on this topic. He has shown that change-allowing talk therapy has actually helped many people. Talking about unwanted same-sex attraction does not automatically, always and everywhere, hurt people. Talk therapy, chosen by the client to achieve their own life goals, does not amount to torture. You know that old expression, a lie is halfway around the world before the truth has its boots on? That certainly applies here. So what are we going to do about it? We need to spread the truth that Sam Brinton is a liar. We need to spread the truth that change-allowing therapy, sexual orientation change efforts as it's sometimes called, this therapy has helped many people. We need your help to get this message out to as many people as possible. Your past support helped us give Susan Constantine a platform when nobody else did. Your past gifts help us support Father Sullins' important research. Your gift today allows us to promote their important findings on social media. Laws based on lies like Sam Brinton's need to go. Help us push back on counseling bans and bans on prayer. Click donate now. I'm Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse for the Ruth Institute. Thank you for joining me.